Thank you for giving me the opportunity to share these data again. So my name's James, I'm a PhD training in Oxford. And what I'm going to try and cover for the next sort of 5 minutes is a little bit about how we've been thinking about how you can try and define human genetic correlates of invasive bacterial disease in Kenyan children at an ethnic context. So if you want to define the human genetic components of any trait in a large population, the experiment that you do is a genome-wide association study, or a GWAS. And this is what we did for bacteremia in Kenyan children in Kilifi, in Adrian Hill's group, in about 2016. And the way that you perform any GWAS and the way that we performed this was to take our bacteremia cases, our population controls, and genotype all of those samples at millions of single nucleoside polymorphisms, so single base pair changes or SNPs, and then correlate genotype with the outcome that you're interested in, so in our case, bacteremia. And what you get out of that is what you can see on the left-hand side there, so a Manhattan plot. So each dot represents a SNP, and how associated it is with bacteremia is how high it plots on the y-axis. And the x-axis is just the physical base pair position on the 22 human autosomes. And what you're hoping to see is genetic loci that are at or above that red line that I've annotated that plot with, so genome-wide significance. And you can see we had a few loci that looked very promising, but when we tried to replicate those in independent sample collections, we weren't able to. So we weren't able to find anything reproducible. And you can imagine that that's for a number of reasons, but almost certainly the most important was simply that we didn't have enough children in that original scan. And so one of the things that we've been thinking about over a number of years was how we might be able to integrate genome-wide association study data sets from the same population in Kilifi with other invasive infections. And the sort of obvious starting point seemed to be to use the malaria-gen genome-wide association study of severe malaria in the same population. But while we were thinking about how we might be able to do that, James Watson, who's a statistician in Oxford, had been thinking about a related problem. So the problem that James was thinking about was that of poor specificity of a clinical diagnosis of severe malaria in high burden settings. So the problem, as James and others have framed it, is that children, when they are well in high burden settings, will often have asymptomatic parasitemia. So when they're critically unwell and they have parasites, those parasites can be present because they're directly causal of their disease process, or they can be incidental. And so what James, over the last couple of years, has been doing is been generating models, in this case using PFHRP2 and platelet count at admission, to give you a probability for each child that you're including in your study that they have true severe malaria. And when we apply those models to children with severe malaria in Kilifi, including in the malaria gen GWAS, you get this interesting result. So a third of those children are very unlikely to have a disease that's directly mediated by their malaria parasites, and so they're critically unwell for some other reason. And importantly, from my perspective, they're highly enriched for bacteremia, so invasive bacterial disease. So using that knowledge, we could then try and fold together a genome-wide association study of culture-proven bacteremia with one of severe malaria. And the way that we've done that is you have shared population controls, bacteremia cases, but for our severe malaria cases, we weight them in the model according to the likelihood that they actually don't have malaria. So they've got what we hypothesise to be culture-negative invasive bacterial disease. And then when you run the scan like that, what you get out of that is this single genome-wide significant locus on chromosome 2, which is on the left-hand side, and then when you zoom in on the right, that haplotype sits over a gene called BIRC6. And then importantly, and this is what we've not been able to do previously, we're able to replicate that finding in an independent sample collection of culture-proven bacteremia with very stable effect sizes. And we've since published that data, and Eli said that sounds appealing, then please do have a look. Obviously, putting together those sorts of data sets takes a lot of people over a long period of time, and at least some of those people I'd like to acknowledge on the right. Thank you very much.